Learning medicine is hard work. Osmosis makes it easy. It takes your lectures and notes to create a personalized study plan with exclusive videos, practice questions, and flashcards, and so much more. Try it free today.
Maple syrup urine disease is a rare genetic metabolic disorder where the body cannot break down branched chain amino acids like valine, leucine, and isoleucine completely, which causes a buildup of these amino acids and their toxic metabolic byproducts. It was named maple syrup urine disease since the urine that contains these metabolites smells like maple syrup. Other names for this disease include branched chain ketoacid dehydrogenase deficiency, or BCKD deficiency, and branched chain ketoaciduria. Now, amino acids are the basic building blocks that make up proteins. There are 20 amino acids used in the human body, and they all contain a carboxyl group and an amine group. The branched chain amino acids have a side chain containing three or more carbons, and they include valine, leucine, and isoleucine. These three are essential amino acids, meaning our bodies can't create them, so you have to get them through protein-rich foods like meat, eggs, dairy, avocados, and beans. So the proteins you eat are broken down into amino acids in the gastrointestinal tract by gastric acid and digestive enzymes. The amino acids are then absorbed by the small intestine into the bloodstream, where they then travel to the cells of the body and are used for protein synthesis. Since the body can't store these amino acids, any extra amino acids are converted into glucose or ketones and used for energy. Branched chain amino acids, which are valine, leucine, and isoleucine, require special steps during their catabolism. First, the enzyme branched chain aminotransferase, or BCAT, strips off their alpha amino group and transfers it to an alpha ketoglutarate to form glutamate. This also converts the branched chain amino acids into branched chain keto acids. Valine is converted into alpha ketoisovalerate, or KIV. Leucine is converted into alpha ketoisocaproate, or KIC. And isoleucine is converted into alpha-keto-beta-methylvalerate, or KMV. In the second step, branched-chain alpha-ketoacid dehydrogenase complex, or BCKD, removes the carboxyl group from these keto acids and turns them into the intermediates, isobutyryl-CoA, isovaleryl-CoA, and alpha-methylbutyryl-CoA. These intermediates will eventually be converted into acetyl-CoA and succinyl-CoA, which are then used by other metabolic processes like the Krebs cycle, ketogenesis, and gluconeogenesis. Maple syrup urine disease is an autosomal recessive disorder, where there's a mutation in at least one of the four genes that codes for the BCKD complex. The more common form of this disease is called the classical form, and it's where there's little to no functional complexes. The less severe form is called the intermediate form, where only 5 to 8% of the complexes are functional when compared to the normal. Decreased BCKD complex activity means that all the branched chain amino acids and their first step metabolites, such as alpha-ketoisovalerate, alpha-ketoisocaproate, and alpha-keto-beta-methylvalerate, build up in the blood and body tissues, like the brain, muscle, and liver. Now, there's a highly selective barrier between the brain tissue and blood vessels called the blood-brain barrier. The blood-brain barrier has amino acid transporters that allow a limited amount of amino acids to cross from the blood into the brain. Leucine binds with higher affinity to these transporters than other amino acids, so they end up occupying most of the transporters. This limits the amount of other amino acids that can enter the brain. Some of these, like tyrosine, tryptophan, and threonine, are used for the synthesis of neurotransmitters like dopamine and serotonin. Now let's zoom into the blood-brain barrier. Some of the metabolites of branched-chain amino acids can also cross over from the blood into the brain. Once they're in the brain, they're converted back into leucine, isoleucine, and valine. But this conversion process uses up other amino acids, like aspartate, glutamine, and alanine. These amino acids are important for brain function and development, especially glutamine, because it's needed to synthesize inhibitory neurotransmitter gamma-aminobutyric acid and excitatory neurotransmitter glutamate. Lack of these two neurotransmitters impairs cell-to-cell communication. Finally, high levels of alpha-ketoisocaproate inhibit the Krebs cycle, which takes place in the mitochondria. This process is necessary for the production of ATP, which is used by sodium-potassium pumps to pump sodium out of the cell and potassium in. This causes a buildup of sodium ions in the cell, which allows water to flow into the cells by osmosis, leading to cellular swelling and cerebral edema. So where does the maple syrup smelling urine come from? Well, isoleucine is spontaneously converted into alloisoleucine in the body. Elevated concentration of plasma alloisoleucine is a sure sign of maple syrup urine disease. Isoleucine and alloisoleucine can also be converted to sotolone, which is the molecule that gives maple syrup and caramel their sweet smell. This molecule is excreted in the urine with other metabolic products, which is why the urine has a distinct sweet odor. Now, symptoms differ based on the form of disease. In classical maple syrup urine disease, the symptoms appear within 48 hours after birth. These include ketonuria with the sweet-smelling urine, irritability, poor feeding, lethargy or sleepiness, and muscle spasm, called opisthotonus, that kind of looks like bicycling movements. If untreated in 7 to 10 days, cerebral edema, seizures, coma, and respiratory failure can occur. In the intermediate form, symptoms appear later in life at irregular intervals. These can be triggered by metabolic stressors, like heavy exercise, infections, or fasting, where the body starts to break down its own proteins. These symptoms include a maple syrup odor of the urine and also the earwax, feeding problems, and delayed growth and development. Diagnosis for maple syrup urine disease is based on the presence of clinical symptoms and lab tests that show elevated valine, leucine, isoleucine, and alloisoleucine in the blood, and increased alpha-ketoisocaproate, alpha-keto-beta-methylvalerate, and alpha-ketoisovalerate in the urine. The main treatment consists of strict diet that limits protein consumption. In people with severe symptoms, hemodialysis is sometimes used to remove the excess amino acids. The only cure is a liver transplantation because the new hepatocytes will have normal levels of BCKD complexes. This procedure is rarely done, and in this case, the individual can still pass the mutation on to their children. All right, as a quick recap, maple syrup urine disease is a rare recessive genetic metabolic disorder where the body can't break down branched chain amino acids like valine, leucine, and isoleucine completely due to a deficiency in branched chain alpha-ketoacid dehydrogenase complexes. This causes the buildup of these amino acids and their metabolites, which can disrupt brain development, neurotransmitter synthesis, cause cerebral edema, and give urine a maple syrup odor. This disorder is diagnosed by elevated plasma levels of valine, leucine, isoleucine, and alloisoleucine in serum, and alpha-ketoisocaproate, alpha-keto-beta-methylvalerate, and alpha-ketoisovalerate in the urine. Treatment for maple syrup urine disease includes dietary restrictions, hemodialysis, and liver transplant.
Thanks for watching. If you're interested in a deeper dive on this topic, take a look at osmosis.org, where we have flashcards, questions, and other awesome tools to help you learn medicine. Otherwise, you can always support us by donating on Patreon, subscribing to our channel, or following us on social media.